I don't normally make a lot of desktop videos, but this is a Dell XPS 8700. This is my own personal machine. I thought I would use it more than I would, or did, but I don't. So, out it goes. I sold it to a friend of mine whose kid games more than I do, but I want to take all my crap off here. Currently, this is an i7-4770 processor. It's got 24 gigs of RAM, and I thought that I was going to do a bit more video editing than I did, which is why I struck this Quadro 5000 2.5 gig video card in there. And that video card, as you can see, has a DVI, DisplayPort, and desk video. But I'm going to pull that out because this is more of a workhorse video card than a gaming video card. And I'll put this guy in here. It's got an HDMI slot. And this is I forget what card this is, to be honest. I think it's a gig. It's an NVIDIA 600 or something. Anyway, I'm going to put that in there. I have my own SSD. I'm going to pull that out. I'm going to put in this one. I have all my data on here. That's a 4 terabyte drive, and I'm going to run this 2 terabyte drive. Load Windows, and then pass it on. But I thought I'd give you an idea of how well this machine ran. This machine runs Windows 10 Pro really well. No issues. And considering that, you know, it's off the shelf, I guess you'd call it. Yeah, it's an off the shelf desktop. It's not a custom build or anything, but it's a nice little system. It's not too bad. A couple things I do like about it. It has two USB 3.0 ports at the very top. It has a couple USB 3.0 ports here. Card reader. USB 3.0. Headphone microphone jack. Like I said, i7-4770. All in all, it's not a bad machine. Alright, I'm going to turn this off as I sacrifice this machine to the computer gods. And then we'll turn it on in a few minutes and see how the rebuild went. But in the meantime, let me show you how this desktop looks and how everything I've got inside it works. Oh, there's a Wi-Fi card too. Okay, this is my last day with this computer. This is a Dell XPS 8700. Actually, let's go into right-click system and you'll see. So it's an i7-4770, 24 gigs of RAM. And if we go into the device manager, if I can remember how to get there from here, right click device manager, you'll see for the video card I was running a Quadro 5000. I think that's 2.5 gigs of space. I removed the DVD drive, that's an external, that Pioneer, and I put in a different drive. So right now it's running the C drive is a 250 gig SSD. The D drive over here is a 4 terabyte drive just for storage, and that's where I've been keeping all the game files. The E drive is the external DVD, and right now I have to use that to burn an ISO, well, a DMG file for a Mac. So the thing is, I don't use this machine at all. I thought I was going to play more games, but you know what? I'm just not playing a lot of games. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to plug in my Xbox controller, which surprisingly just works like that out of the box. I mean, when you plug it into a Windows machine, which I really like. Will it be under here? It's one of these guys. Keyboards, mice, monitors, network adapters. Yeah, it's got Wi-Fi built in, Bluetooth built in. This is a really nice desktop. Well, there it is, Xbox 360. So there's my controller. Yeah, it's a really nice machine. I enjoy using it. And I thought, like I said, that I'd be playing this more often, but I'm not. So if I go into Halo and I play Halo, let's play Halo. Just so you can see how it's playing with like this 2.5 gig machine, you know what I mean? I think it's working pretty well. Now the question is it going to record the internal sounds? I don't know. But yeah, I really like this machine. The thing is, a friend of mine's got a kid, and she needed more of a gaming PC than I did for the kid. Okay, press enter to start. Okay, stop. And exit somehow or other. Exit, save, quit. There we go. Sweet, don't you think? I think it plays pretty well. So that's Steam. I don't know what else you want to play on there, but I don't have a lot of games on here. Okay. You've seen the machine. You know what I like. Let's take another look at it on the inside. Where's OBS? Look at the size of that card. That's crazy. And I know there's bigger cards out there. And I do have the... you can get a bridge, and you can bridge them if you want to do like an SDI, which means you can run two cards in tandem. Basically, it just goes in. I think it goes in up there. So what happens is if you have two of these, you bridge them together, and then it creates double the horsepower, basically. So that guy will be put away. I should attach that bridge to it so I don't lose it. This card is going to be going in. Like I said, I don't even know what card this is, but I'm sure Windows 10 will pick up the drivers. I'll have to see if I can find another slot to go in there. And I took out the SSD. There it is there. Debating if I'm going to put in the 180. Because my problem with the 180 is that if I put that in there, they're just a kid and they're going to start loading up their C drive with all the games. Well, you don't want your games on your C drive. You want your games on your D drive, and the C drive is just the operational. That's why I usually throw in like a 1 terabyte if I had one, but I don't. So I think we'll stick with the 2 terabyte and put that in there. I'll pull the 4 out. And I think I have max RAM in there. I don't think I have any RAM. Like, this is a 4 gig stick of PC312-800. I don't think I have anything bigger or faster than that, so. I think they've got 2 8s and 2 4s. Okay, done, 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 and done. That doesn't need power. Gonna pull this guy out. Okay, so the video card is seated in there. You can see that. I made this the C drive, so that's a 2 terabyte drive. I tagged and left this drive available so they know that that is for a secondary drive. Then I tagged and left the power out. This is for the video card. As you can see, it says video card power in case they decide to add a video card. So now I'm going to load Windows onto this drive, which is their C drive. Well, this would be their C drive, 2 terabytes. It's going to be kind of slow, but I'm hoping that they will, well, take it apart, learn how to fix it themselves. All right, let's get to that and I'll be right back. It's hard to do both things while holding the camera. That's why I'm only going intermittently here. Okay, so everything's in there. We booted up. Let's just dive into the BIOS really quick. So you can see it's the i7-4770. It recognizes the RAM, 24 gigs. Recognize the... I gotta find the hard drive. SATA 1. Device type empty. SATA 2. Empty. Advanced processor configuration, that's fine. Onboard device, AHCI. Okay, it is not RAID, I can tell you that much. Boot mode. Internal hard drive devices, okay, that's fine. Power, security, exit. I want to see those. See, it's not showing the hard drive. Oh. It's not showing the hard drive. All right, well, maybe I gotta change that hard drive a bit. Maybe that's the problem. Exit with a saving, quit with a saving. I don't want to save. Okay, so you can see the installation's going pretty well. I ended up having to change things up a bit And I went with the 180 gig SSD and threw in a 3 terabyte as a storage, because what was happening was when I was trying to install a 2 terabyte, I was getting an error saying, hey, this drive is failing, we can't install Windows. So, live and learn. Well, I think he'll be okay with this. Okay, so we got it up and running. I put the 180 gig in there. When I was trying to install Windows earlier, I kept saying the 2 terabyte drive was dying. So I recycled that and installed a 3 terabyte. Now, the problem with the 3 terabyte is that Windows 10 only recognizes 2 terabyte and then the extra. So it's showing like 790 gig or something. I'm just going to install OBS now on this machine. We'll switch over to OBS and then you can see how it's doing component-wise. And that is that. Okay, so I'm recording on the other camera too, as well as OBS. So, fresh install of Windows 10 Pro. You can see it's an i7-4770, 3.4 gigahertz, 24 gigs of RAM, 64-bit OS, Windows 10 Pro version 1909. The screen's a little funny shaped because it's a 1050, even though once he puts a 1080 screen or whatever he puts in there, it's going to work just fine and dandy. I have not attached any speakers to it yet. The only thing I've attached is this Yeti microphone. But yeah, it should be a pretty good little system for him. I think that he will appreciate it. You can see the way I like to do my systems is I like to have, under this PC, I like to have my storage, not my storage, I like to have my regular disk, which is the C drive, which will hold the operating system and any pertinent applications. And then I like to keep the D drive for data. So that's where I'll store like my videos, my pictures. If you're going to run games in Steam, I like to put the games on the D drive. This is actually a 3 terabyte drive, but only 2 terabytes is showing up. And that's because that's all Windows 10 recognizes. Yet if you go into it, let's see, disk management, right click, you'll see it pops up here with this unallocated little bit. And I can create a simple partition in there, or I can maybe adjust this partition, but gives you an idea of how it all works out. You ever play with the disk manager on Windows? That's not too bad. I prefer it actually over the Mac version, but that's just my 2 cents. Okay, so OBS is installed, Steam is installed, Edge is always there. Can't get much past that. The new Edge, though, is really nice. But can we download the new Edge, I wonder? Anyway, we won't get into that. Just want to go through the machine really quick. Simple. It runs fast. I mean, for an i7-4770, this machine can definitely handle anything you throw at it in 2020. I don't know what kind of frames per second it's going to get on, say, GTA 5. But PUBG, Fortnite, stuff like that, this shouldn't have too much of a problem. New Edge browser download. I don't think I am going to download it, but yeah, it's got this cool little symbol over there. Isn't that neat? All right, I think that's it. Back to our regular scheduled video. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. Hit that big thumbs up if that's your game, and don't forget that subscribe button, which is down over here somewhere. And we shall talk again soon, one day. Thanks for watching. So, if you like these kind of videos, thumbs up. If not, thumbs down. Let me know what you think. Hit that subscribe button right here and that little bell. And we shall talk again. Now, on a side note, I do have a Dell XPS 13 coming in that I just picked up. And I think that's going to be the next video. I'm just deciding on what operating system to put on it. I think it's going to be Windows. We'll see. Anyway, enjoy your day. Thanks for watching. Did I mention that it was Star Wars Day yesterday or 2 days ago?